Hey pool owners, in this video we're going to show you how to program your Pentair IntelliFlo VF. Let's jump right in.
Okay, let's start with going over the control panel of the IntelliFlo VF. Up in the upper left hand corner you see the filter button. That's what's probably going to be running in most of the time for you. Then you have a vacuum, backwash, the manual, you have a select, escape, got the menu over here. You got your arrows to navigate through the different menus, your enter button. You got your feature button down here, feature one, feature two. Those would be like waterfalls, any other type of water feature that you have. Start stop button for the pump and reset. Over here, you'll see these LEDs. The top one's lit right now. That just means it's on. The next one down, if that were to be lit, that would be the warning. If there's any potential issues, maybe the filter, you know, is close to, you know, being cleaned. Down here you have an alarm. That means the pump is, there's definitely something wrong. It's shut down. Up here on the LED display, line one is the mode. And you can see right now it says filter. Line two is the data. So right now it's not running, so it's saying 0 watts. Line three is the name of the data in line two. So that's just telling you that's the power consumption right now. And then line four is the run status, and it's currently stopped. Okay, before we get into the programming, for a lot of pools, you'll want to first run it in a manual mode. So you would just hit manual, and then you could hit start, and then you could play around with the gallons per minute or the RPMs to figure out, you know, what's going to work for you. Like, let's say you have a salt system and it requires, you know, 15 gallons per minute. You'll need to figure out what the RPM is on here first before you start programming. So I would, you know, play around a little bit with the manual, make sure you get everything calculated first before you dive into the programming. All right, once you've figured out what your pool is going to require, you can start programming the pump. So the first thing you want to do is get to the pool data mode. And all you have to do is hit menu. I'll bring you to the pool data mode. And press select. Okay, so we're not going to do anything with the pump address. That's just if you had more than one pump or you're tying it to an IntelliTouch system, you'll need to number them if you had more than one. We can leave it at one for this example because most people are just going to have this one standalone pump. But the first thing you'll want to change is the gallonage. And we can see that here. So it's currently set at 25,000 gallons. And we'll hit select. And using the arrows, you can change the numbers. So let's say it's a 35,000 gallon pool. Got that set here. So then we can hit enter and your gallons are set. Hit the down arrow to set the water temperature. This you'll have to manually test, so using a thermometer test the water, and then you can come back and set the temperature. So we'll do that, and let's say the current water temperature is 75. Move it over to 75, then hit enter, and now your temperature is set. All right, once the temperature is set, you can hit escape to take you back to the main menu. And the next one we're going to program is the priming. It's basically when the pump first turns on. You'll want it to run in a higher speed to get the pump fully primed. We'll hit select there. And from the factory it comes set on 55 gallons per minute, but you can change that. Let's say you want it to run at 60 gallons per minute. Set that and hit enter. And then it's the duration. The factory defaults 15, but you know, most pools it doesn't take that long. So let's say, you know, we change it to 10. And this is different for every pool, so if you find that you need, you know, more gallons per minute or maybe you need the full 15 minutes, that's going to be different on every pool. So again, it's trial and error. But let's say we're going to go with 10 minutes here. And we hit enter. And then that is the settings for the priming. So then again, you hit escape. All right, the next part we're going to program is the filter setting. And with the, before you do the filter setting, you want to make sure your filter is clean because it's going to detect pressure within the system. So with the filter clean, you'll hit select. And then you can see here it currently says 10 PSI. Basically, that means it's assuming that your filter is clean right now. Once it detects there's a 10 PSI increase, it's going to give you an alert to clean the filter, and then you'll have to reset the pump. But if you wanted to change it, you know, the most common range is going to be anywhere from 10 to 20 PSI. So if you wanted to change that, let's say that you want it to be 15, you can change it. Arrows, hit enter. And then once it detects there's been a 15 PSI increase, then it'll sound the alert and you'll have to clean the filter and reset the pump. After the PSI, you'll want to change the turnovers per day or not change it. It's currently set at 1. I mean, that's the most common turnover rate for a residential pool. You know, but you could change that to 2 or 3 turnovers per day. Again, 1 is what's required. So most people will keep it there. All right, next up is cycles per day. This is how many times the pump will turn on and off to complete that one turnover. Again, I'd say most people are going to just go 1 cycle, but if you wanted 2 cycles to maybe run a few hours in the morning and then stop and then run a few hours in the evening, you could set 2 cycles. Again, most people are going to leave it at 1, but if you wanted to change it again, you just hit select and then change it and then hit enter. Okay, then here we have the time. So this is basically when it's going to turn on, and right now it's currently set to 8 a.m. And if you wanted it to stay there, you just hit enter. And then the second one's going to be the stop cycle. So just hit select. And then you can change it to, let's say, 6 p.m. And hit enter. And then it'll turn off your cycle at 6 p.m. Now, in between that time, in between 8 a.m. and 6 p.m., it's going to turn over your body of water once. All right, once you've set the end of your stop cycle, you just hit escape and take you back to the main menu. And then the next category is going to be time and contrast. So you can hit select. And currently it says it's 6:53 a.m. If that's not accurate, you can go in here and change it to the current time. Let's say it's 7 a.m. and hit enter. Okay, so after time, if you want, you can change the contrast level. For most people, 5 is sufficient, but it goes from 0 to 10. You'd avoid, you know, wanting to go to 0 unless you're unable to read the screen due to a really bright sunlight. But again, I would suggest, you know, if you starting at 5, and if you have to, you can change it. All right, then after the contrast is set, you can hit escape and go down to features. Again, you just hit select. So again, these buttons down here, feature 1, feature 2, these are going to be for maybe if you have a spa, if attached spa, you know, you'd be able to hit this button. It would kick the jets up to a high level. Or if you have maybe deck jets or waterfalls, you can set those here. All right, so let's say, you know, you have a waterfall and that's your feature. And that could be feature 1. You'd hit select, and then you'd have to select the gallons per minute for that water feature. So let's say your waterfall requires 60 gallons per minute. You'd hit select again, over. And now it's at 60, hit enter. And then the time. So let's say, you know, you press this button and you want your waterfall to turn on for an hour. You can go in here and change. It's currently set for 30 minutes. Just hit select, over. and now it's set for 1 hour. You just hit enter. And then if you had a second feature, you would just hit escape. And then that brings up feature two, and then you do the same exact thing you just did for feature one to set feature two. And then once you're done setting the features, you just hit escape, you hit down. You'll see external control. Really, you only need to worry about that if you have an IntelliCom communication center. And if you have one of those, I would just refer to the manual that comes with the pump. It starts on page 28, and that can walk you through that. Most people aren't going to have the IntelliCom center. So the next thing we'd set is the backwash. So basically, again, when previously we had set the pump to tell you when the PSI has raised about 15 pounds. And so at that point, you would see an alarm, and it would tell you to backwash. So this is basically, if you have a sand or DE filter, it's very important to have these dialed in correctly. So once it's on backwash, you just hit select. And then however many gallons per minute your filter is going to take to backwash, that's what you'll set here. You know, an average would be about 60 gallons per minute. And but if you need to change that, again, it's select, go in, put it up or down, and hit enter. The duration average is about 5 minutes, but again, you do the same steps to change anything. Just hit select and then dial it in, hit enter. The last one here is rinse. And that usually doesn't take as long as backwashing, so you can set it to a minute or two. And that's all you have to do to set the backwash. Once that's done, you just hit the escape. One more thing about the backwash mode. I know we covered sand DE filters, but even if you have a cartridge filter, you still need to hit backwash, because basically that's gonna tell the pump that the system is now clean. It can reset the PSI, and you can continue. After backwash, you'll see the vacuum setting. And this is when you want to manually vacuum the pool. Again, we'll hit select. You can set the gallons per minute. Let's say, to manually vacuum the pool, you need 60 gallons per minute. So you just hit select. And we got it set at 60 gallons per minute now. So you hit enter. And the vacuum duration, let's say it takes you 20 minutes. You hit select. There we have a 20 minute set. You said enter. And that's all you need to do for the vacuum setting. And once you get through the vacuum setting, that's really all you need to do to program the IntelliFlow VF.
That wraps up how to program your variable speed pool pump. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below, and don't forget to visit us over at inyopools.com for all your swimming pool needs. Thanks for watching.